What is up, Backroad Explorers? Saturday morning, Mike's crew joined me last night around 11 o'clock, and we are just outside of Goblin Valley. We're on Behind the Reef Road, and we're going to be doing something that I wish we did a lot more of, which is we're going to explore a ton in a small area. So a lot of times we're going, you know, pretty decent distances between points, but today there's tons of really cool spur trails, and we're going to be going and just trying to see as many of those as we possibly can throughout the day. So let's hit the trail. We started the day off right by jumping off of Behind the Reef Road and heading north on Forest Road NF-4104, right next to camp. Thanks to your feedback, we're going to try and provide the tracks for each trip for download. If you click the link above, you can check out our tracks to follow along and make the trip yourself. NF-4104 is a short, windy trail that connects Behind the Reef Road and West Temple Junction Road. We really enjoyed making our way through the rocky terrain. Once on Temple Junction Road, we picked up the pace and took advantage of the well-graded road to cover some ground and put a few miles behind us as we made our way to check out the family view. After stopping for a few minutes to check out Family Butte, we were back on the trail looking for more spur trails.
We quickly fell in love with these trails, which offered the perfect combination of rocks and obstacles combined with beautiful views. Our route weaved through the desert, climbing up small hills and dropping down into washes, offering a lot of variety to take in on the trail. I'm still amazed that the day before we were high in the mountains, watching the leaves change and fall, turning up the heat every now and then to keep warm, and really taking in fall weather. Now, just a few hours away, we are deep into the desert and soaking in the red dirt and rocks. If you've not already, please subscribe to our channel so you can catch every trip. This is a section where I hate how poorly video showcases an obstacle and steepness. This steep hill looks almost flat, and the ledges look just like small rocks, but in reality this section was a ton of fun and more exciting than the footage displays. Several miles into Behind the Reef Trail, Mike and I knew we had planned way too many miles for the day, but also incredibly happy with how amazing this trail was and excited to see everything it had to offer. Despite our goal to explore as many spur trails as possible, we had to pass up a bunch in order to somewhat stay on track to finish before dark. I've already started routing out another trip to hit some of the spur trails we had to pass up. Mike's trying to decide next what to do to his Forerunner. I believe adding a lift is at the top of the list. If you have one and have any recommendations, let us know in the comments. The deeper we got into Behind the Reef Trail, the better the obstacles, with several very rocky sections where choosing the right line was starting to really matter. With so much trail left to cover, including the most technical section of the trip, I decided rather than cutting out more and more footage that I really wanted to showcase, it would be better to split day 2 into 2 parts. If you enjoyed this video, please like and share, and make sure to hit that subscribe button to catch the next part. Thanks for watching.